But it always has amazed people that Darwin and Wallace in 1858 came out with an essentially identical, at least highly similar, interpretation of evolution. The question was asked, well, what in their background has led them to that similarity? Well, I shall not, there are usually three or four factors indicated, but one of them is that they have been in the tropics and have studied the fauna of tropical islands. And that indeed is a most important experience that any naturalist, any evolutionist can have, and that has been my fortune that I've had this experience. And not only have I gone from island to island, and this includes mountain ranges in New Guinea, which are islands in the lowlands and show exactly the same phenomena as low-lying islands in the ocean. But the importance of barriers among islands, the differences of different populations on different islands, the differences between big islands and little islands, all this sort of thing inevitably leads you to theories of speciation and leads you to the application of these theories of speciation to other evolutionary phenomena, including even macroevolution. Now, it isn't, in my case, I was even fortunate that then not only I saw these islands, but I was permitted to work out the scientific results of the collections and was able to compare particular species from island to island to island, which showed the pathway of evolution. And the study of such collections, as both Wallace and Darwin knew, is of incredibly high value.